Welcome back to Barrio Tales. Today's video will be about Orphans 13 versus West Trece in Orange County. West Trece is a well-documented criminal street gang in the city of Westminster. Sigler Park is located within West's claimed territory and is its members' primarily hangout or gathering point. Members and affiliates of West particularly congregate near the handball courts at Sigler Park. Orphans is a Hispanic criminal street gang that is one of West's rivals. Part 1. Late one night, a group of family and friends gathered at a house in Westminster, California to socialize. Among those present were Christian Pedroza, a known affiliate of the Orphan criminal street gang, and a few of his cousins, including Jose and Giovanni Fuentes. Christian Pedroza and others were talking and drinking beer in the garage when Giovanni decided to leave on his bicycle. A gray car approached the house on the street, and from inside the car, someone yelled, "West Trece and bullet." The group inside the garage ran out toward the street. Pedroza threw a marijuana pipe at the car, and Jose did the same with a beer bottle. The gray car drove off, but a second car, which had been parked nearby, drove fast toward Pedroza and the others with its lights off. Everyone at the house got out of the way of the oncoming car, and it sped off in the same direction as the gray car. Approximately 10 minutes later, while Pedroza and others were still standing in the driveway of the house, two males wearing black hooded sweatshirts approached on foot, hiding behind parked cars along the way. Shots rang out. Pedroza's wife ran inside the house, called 911, and ran back out to the driveway area. She noticed the garage door was closed. When she opened it, she saw Pedroza lying face down on the ground. Police arrived and found four men on the ground with gunshot wounds. Pedroza and Giovanni ultimately succumbed to their wounds. The two others, including Jose, were treated at hospitals and survived. Police officers interviewed Jose at the hospital. He relayed to an officer that Bullet was one of the two shooters and that Bullet shot five or more times. The other shooter fired three shots. Thereafter, Jose identified a picture of Javier Solorzano as being that of Bullet and identified the other shooter in a photographic lineup. Javier Solorzano, who was known by law enforcement to be an active member of the West Trece criminal street gang and whose moniker was Bullet, was located by officers the morning after the shooting. After some surveillance, they arrested him. He asked that they not make a big scene in front of his house and stated he knew what this was about. The same day, Javier voluntarily spoke to police. He related that he knew the area where the shooting took place was West Trece gang territory, and the particular house was occupied by Orphan gang members. Although initially he denied any involvement in the murders, he eventually admitted to being in the area on the night in question. He claimed he picked up a friend, and when someone threw a beer bottle at his car, he took off. Later that night, someone told him about the shooting. The next day, Javier again voluntarily spoke with a police detective. His story was different than it was the day before, and it further evolved during the course of the interview. Eventually, he admitted to going by the house twice on the night of the shooting, accompanied by two others, Hydro and Raul. The first time they drove by, one male standing in the driveway supposedly held a machete, another had a long pole, and a third threw a beer bottle at Javier's car. When Javier returned to the house on foot not long thereafter, he told the rival gang member on the driveway that he wanted Travisio. Travisio was Orphan affiliate, Christian Pedroza's moniker. According to Javier, the group threw another thing at him and charged him, and that was it. Javier took a gun from Hydro, held it with his tank top so he would not leave fingerprints on it, fired multiple shots toward the group, and then handed the gun back to Hydro. He claimed he felt threatened and acted in self-defense. Eventually, West Trece gang member Javier Bullet Solorzano was charged with the double first-degree murders of Christian Pedroza and Giovanni Fuentes and two counts of attempted murder. Javier Bullet Solorzano was sentenced to life in prison without parole. Part 2. On September 9, 2010, Enrique, who was a member of Orphans 13, started drinking alcohol around 3 p.m. By 5:30 p.m., he had consumed like an 18-pack of beer and was a little tipsy. Around 6:30 p.m., he was driving his black Toyota Camry in the area of Sigler Park and became bored, so he decided to drive around Sigler Park to see what was going on. Enrique knew Sigler Park was inside Wes's claimed territory, and that was where Wes's members would often hang out. He had seen them there. He also knew it was disrespectful for a gang member to go inside a rival gang's claimed territory, and if a member does so and causes trouble, the member will probably get dealt with. When Enrique went to Sigler Park, he saw 5 or 6 people from West Trece. After Enrique drove around the park 3 times, they threw up West Trece, meaning they yelled out their gang name. Enrique threw out his neighborhood by yelling back Orphans, and that's what started it. He claimed he knew his conduct might have caused trouble, and claimed he then tried to leave. The West Trece gang members started running toward Enrique's car, and Enrique floored it. The West Trece members threw objects at Enrique's car, which shattered his windshield, and he ducked down. He looked out the driver's side window and saw a male pointing a gun at him. He did not see the gunman's face. Enrique accelerated his car and heard shots. He saw a brown-colored minivan speed away. Later that night, Enrique was pulled over by the police for driving under the influence. A police officer observed 2 bullet entry holes on the driver's side door frame of the Camry and that the rear passenger window was shattered or broken. It was evident now that Enrique from Orphans 13 had his car get shot up by West Trece. In street terminology, that's what it means when you hear the phrase, your car get flipped. A witness who lived near Sigler Park saw a man standing outside of a brown-colored minivan on the passenger side holding a black gun and aiming it at a black Camry. She heard at least 3 shots and saw the driver of the Camry drive away. She also saw the shooter run into the minivan and the minivan drive away. After the witness described the shooter, a booking photo was shown to the witness. This would lead to the identification of a West Trece gang member named Gustavo Barrera Olmedo. Police had an accomplice also charged in the shooting called Gustavo and set up a recording device on the person's phone who called Gustavo. The accomplice told Gustavo that he, the accomplice, was in trouble as the police had come to his house and identified him involved in the shooting at Sigler Park. The caller also told Gustavo he, Gustavo, had been identified. Gustavo told the caller to get off the phone and don't talk on the phone, then said goodbye. On September 15, 2010, Gustavo Olmedo was arrested in Victorville. During Gustavo's interview, Gustavo explained that before the shooting occurred, he was dropped off at Sigler Park by 2 people. Gustavo said he heard some gunshots and then refused to talk anymore. 2 accomplices, including the caller with the recording device, took plea deals. West Trece gang member Gustavo Barrera Olmedo was charged with the attempted murder of Enrique from Orphans Gang. West Trece gang member Gustavo Barrera Olmedo was found guilty with attempted murder and shooting at an occupied motor vehicle. Gustavo Olmedo was sentenced to 35 years to life in prison.